पत्रकारको आजको श्रृङ्खलामा यहाँहरूलाई स्वागत छ। आज हामीसँग हुनुहुन्छ जेम्स लङ, सदर्न डेमोक्रेटिक अलायन्स पार्टीका अध्यक्ष हुनुहुन्छ। सधैँभन्दा आज अलिकति फरक इन्टरभ्यू हुनेछ। आज हामी आजको अन्तर्वार्तालाई अङ्ग्रेजीमा प्रश्नोत्तरी गर्नेछौँ, तसर्थ यहाँहरूले यो अन्तर्वार्ता सधैँझै इन्जोय गर्नुहुनेछ भन्ने विश्वास लिएका छौँ। स्वागत गरौँ जेम्स लङलाई। वेलकम टु द सो।
नमस्ते, नमस्ते।
ओके मिस्टर जेम्स, आई जस्ट टोल्ड अबाउट सदर्न डेमोक्रेटिक अलायन्स एन्ड योर सेल्फ, या यु आर द पार्टी चिफ एज वेल। प्लिज टेल अस समथिङ अबाउट योर सेल्फ फर्स्ट, एन्ड लाइक वेन यु वर बोर्न एन्ड योर एजुकेसन ब्याकग्राउन्ड एन्ड अल।
ओके, आई was born in 1974 in August. That means now I have already 41 years old. Yeah, still younger than you are. Just okay. Yeah, so I have studied in Lingnan University in 1993 to 1996. I studied politics.
Okay.
And then, as many people know, I have studied in Hong Kong Polytechnic University. Mm-hmm. Social work in 2003 to 2007.
Okay, so it was just a brief introduction about yourself. Mm. Now let's talk about Southern Democratic Alliance. Mm. How did you have an idea of establishing a political party in Hong Kong? Mm. When did you start it?
Okay, from 2002, uh-huh. October, uh-huh. I have set up an office in Jordan to work for people in Jordan.
Okay.
At that time, we are not looking for particularly helping the ethnic minorities. Mm-hmm. So we are serving the local elderly.
Mm-hmm.
But and then many elderly ask the same questions.
Yes.
Oh, James, you are from the university. Can you help us to be the interpreter?
Okay.
Yeah, why? Because the the elderly, mm-hmm. they rent the room to the ethnic minorities.
Okay.
They separate their fat into different parts, mm-hmm. and rent to the ethnic minorities. Mm-hmm. And it is expensive,
mm-hmm.
to ask the property agent for the translation.
Mm-hmm.
So, because we are free of charge, so that they asked me for help, and then by that way, I lost so many Nepalese fans.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you started your political party in 2002?
And then in 2003, everybody know there are series of political issues in 2003.
Okay.
And then some ethnic minorities also joined the district council election.
Okay.
And in Jordan, there is a Nepalese who joined the election.
Okay.
And I helped him.
Okay.
And then he has got a good percentage of votes.
Okay.
Even he was lost. Okay. And then some Nepalese think,
okay,
it is good to cooperate with a good Chinese friend,
okay.
to set a political party,
okay.
and then to bargain to the government, mm-hmm. For the benefit of the Nepalese and other ethnic minorities.
Okay, so you started, when did you start your party?
2004 1st February.
Okay, 2004 1st February. Okay, since then you have been working with the since 2002 you have been working with the Nepalese community, isn't it? Okay, so tell us something about your political party, Southern Democratic Alliance. Can you tell us something about your party?
Okay, actually, it is not a very restricted and constricted party.
Okay.
It is a little bit loosened.
Okay.
Because we understand Nepalese people are like freestyle.
Okay.
So if the system is too restricted, it is
local. Okay.
So, for example, in 2006,
okay.
we worked with some Nepalese, including Sowan Kuma,
okay.
Limbu Sowan Kuma, to ask the government to have the radio program in ethnic minorities language in RTHK.
Okay.
So now you can see there are Nepalese, Hindu,
mm-hmm.
Urdu,
mm-hmm.
Indonesia and Tagalog language program in LTHK.
Oh, okay.
And also in 2008, I joined the Legislative Council election with the Heavenly Path.
Okay.
Yeah. The candidate is called it's called Bantawa Sukai.
Okay.
So, surely we lose. It is very difficult for ethnic minorities to join the election game because the election means if you want to win the election, it should be majority.
Okay. Yes. Yes.
But even though we lose, we gain popularity.
Okay.
More and more people pay attention to ethnic minorities, pay attention to the police community.
Okay.
And in the same year, we joined the election, the racial discrimination audience also passed in the Legislative Council election.
Okay.
So I think we have done a good job.
Okay. So you have been connected with the Nepalese community since 2002 and you formed a party in 2004, February 1, yeah? So can you tell me how our Nepalese community in Hong Kong been connected to your party? How are they connected to your party? What do you feel about the Nepalese community here in Hong Kong?
Okay, so in my personal opinion,
yes,
Nepalese people are very good, loyal, and very friendly. So I cannot calculate how many times I joined the BBQ party in the Monkey Hill, and I also cannot calculate how many families, Nepalese family, I have visited them. So they are good. In my sense, for example, about the children, most of them are successfully joined the local school.
Okay.
So they need to try their best to keep with the education system.
Okay.
It is very difficult. Okay. Not only Nepalese people, even Chinese local, they think it is not easy to suit the system. Do you know about the TSA?
What is that?
A TSA, it is crazy government policy.
Okay.
They in primary three, primary six,
okay,
secondary three, secondary six, before the graduation, they will calculate. They will have examinations and assessment and make all the students in Hong Kong the ranking, who is more careful, whose academic result is good, who is not good, who is bad. But we think that primary three, TSA, it is crazy.
Okay.
Primary three, only 8 years old?
Yeah.
What do you think? Yeah. In my opinion, 8 years old, children should be happy, play around, and more time to be with their parents.
Okay, since you have been talking about the education system in Hong Kong, we see a lot of Nepalese students who are not able to join the university because they drop out after form 6. They usually drop out form 4, 5, form 6. They usually drop out and they are not able to go to the university. So do you think your party will be able to help those Nepalese students who are not able to go to the university? How do you think that you can help?
Actually, we are helping them in two ways. Firstly, we are still continuously talking with the government and the universities.
Okay.
We don't think Chinese language is the most important language in the universities.
Okay.
For example, in medicals, law, and different subjects, the main language, the official language is English.
Yes.
As for example, if it is Chinese history, Chinese culture, it is another story.
Yes,
yeah? So we are thinking, we talk with them, it is low use to look after the child, to look at the Chinese academic result if they want to join the, if they want to become a lawyer or want to become a doctor.
Yeah, okay.
So secondly, surely we also explore some opportunities for universities from outside from international. If they have suitable courses for Lebanese people to join, because the international courses surely low Chinese required.
So you'll be helping this way to the Nepalese students, yeah? Okay. So now let's talk about the Nepalese society in Hong Kong. Since you have been involved in with and working with the Nepalese society in Hong Kong, what do you see is a major problem among Nepalese society in Hong Kong?
In my personal opinion, the major problem it is that they are lack of information and knowledge from the government. You can imagine now most of the Nepalese people are working in construction sites. From 8 p.m. to from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Or if you find you are working in a night shift, it is another story for me. So take very long time. After working, they go home. Very short time, they enjoy their dinner with their family, and then enjoy some good time with their family, and then sleep. They have no time to turn on the TV, English channel TV, news, and then turn on the radio for information. They have no time. So in many occasions, they will come to ask me. They will have their day off, and then they come to ask me for the for how to solve some different kinds of problems.
So yeah, that is a major problem among Nepalese society in Hong Kong. Actually, they are not well aware of government policies and government facilities as well. So hopefully you'll be doing more for the Nepalese society in the coming days. Thank you. Now let's talk about Nepalese society and the Chinese community, the major community here in Hong Kong. So what do you feel about the relation between the Nepalese community and the major Chinese community here in Hong Kong? What do you feel about the relationships between these two communities?
I think the most important part, it is the mutual understanding. If Nepalese people here, Chinese people here, they don't interact and they don't make contact, surely they don't understand. So, for example, since 2005, I have joined the Sumsipo Council, District Council, Committee of Ethnic Minorities, and become the member up to now. So, I want to show the Chinese people we need to organize some program. Not only for the Nepalese people. We organize program with Nepalese people and local Chinese, and they will understand more. And also, for example, my member, Lim Bu Suan Kuma, the major, now he is sitting in the Ethnic Minority Forum of the Home Affairs Board. So, time to time, they join the meeting, they expect the Nepalese opinion, idea. So the local Chinese and the Hong Kong government will steadily understand more and more about what the Nepalese people think.
So now let me ask you a critical question. What I have heard, but I'm not quite sure, that the local Chinese media doesn't present the Nepalese community quite well when they write news about the Nepalese community. They don't write very good about the Nepalese community. What do you think about that? I'm not very sure, but I've heard about this problem. What do you think about this?
In my opinion, we can discuss this issue in some parts. Firstly, for example, sometimes I also organize programs and invite the reporters. So for example, about the earthquake, the Nepalese earthquake, I invite the reporters to the Hindu Mandir to see how we organize, how we give the donations and material to Nepal. So they write very good articles. And why? Because The local Chinese here.
Okay.
Local Chinese can explain to them
mm-hmm.
why we do it like this, why we do
mm-hmm.
it like this, and they understand.
Mm-hmm.
So they can write good articles.
Okay.
But you sometimes they don't write, they do not write good articles.
Uh-huh.
For example, if some robbers,
okay.
Some you see sometimes, you know, even
uh-huh.
policemen,
uh-huh.
they cannot. They cannot distinguish, oh, the robber is Nepalese,
okay.
or the robber is Indian or Pakistanis,
okay.
no problem. The robber is South Asian.
Okay.
So, they are confusing.
Yes, there is a problem with the mainstream media, but then I have been reading the English mainstream media, which have been presenting the Nepalese contribution to Hong Kong quite well these days.
Yeah,
yeah, that is a positive point. But then the Chinese mainstream media should think about this part as well, I feel. Okay, now let's
So I think the most important part, for example, you are very good, you take me here to have the interview in English.
Okay.
So not only Nepalese people,
uh-huh.
but also Chinese people will understand
uh-huh.
and they will think more positively about the Nepalese society.
Okay, yeah, thank you. And now let's, we are about to finish the interview, maybe 2 or 3 minutes will take more. Can you tell about, now what are your future plans with the Nepalese society, your party and the Nepalese society, what are your future plans?
Okay, in my opinion, because my party is multi-ethnic, so if we if they can manage the party in a good way, and then I can retire,
uh-huh.
and it will be a very good ending.
Uh-huh.
You know, the party is not belong to me.
Okay, yes.
The party is not belong to particular Chinese
uh-huh.
or particular one person.
Mm-hmm.
So we are trying very best to introduce our party member to different government.
Okay.
Department and committee, so they will have experience and they can contribute to the party and the local ethnic society.
Okay, so you are planning to bring more ethnic minorities individuals to your party and just in your higher post as well, yes?
Yes, sure. For example, now Lim Bo Seng Kuma is representing our party to the Home Affairs Board Ethnic Minority Forum.
Okay, okay.
Low lead me.
Okay. Now, let's talk about, we have been talking about future things as well. Your party believes in democracy, I believe.
Yeah.
Yes. So, what do you think about democracy in Hong Kong?
In my opinion, so, because we have been more than 100 years a British colony.
Uh-huh.
So, according to the British tradition,
mm.
democracy means we choose some capable person,
yes, yes.
and the capable person will representing us to talk in the government.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
uh-huh.
it is good.
Uh-huh.
But in my opinion, we need to do very hard to monitor that person.
Uh-huh, yes,
because
yes.
We should know whatever he or she has spoke for us or not.
Uh-huh. Yes.
We cannot just vote for him and then, okay, oh, I believe you.
Okay.
Yeah, it is
okay.
So good.
Okay. So we are at the end of our interview. Anything that you would like to tell to our viewers?
So in my opinion, I have born in Hong Kong.
Uh-huh.
So many Nepalese are also born in Hong Kong.
Uh-huh.
So do other ethnic minorities. So Hong Kong is not only belong to Chinese.
Okay.
Hong Kong belong to you, me, so we need to be friends and make Hong Kong more beautiful, more happy place to live. Thank you.
So, dear viewers, we have here today James Leung, the chairperson of the Southern Democratic Alliance. We'll be inviting leaders from different political parties in Hong Kong and we'll be having an interview with them too, and we'll be trying to convey their message to the Nepalese society here in Hong Kong. Thank you very much for watching us today. Namaste.
Bye bye. Namaste.